In this video, we're going to learn the basics about how to add fractions. Now, a lot of math books will teach you how to add fractions before they teach you how to multiply them. But here at Math Antics, we think you should learn the other way around. You remember how easy it is to multiply fractions, right? You just multiply the top numbers together, and you multiply the bottom numbers together, and you have your answer. So you might be wondering, well, can't we just do that with addition too? Can't we just add the top numbers together and add the bottom numbers together and get our answer? Well, all right, let's try it and see, but I got a bad feeling about this. Let's try adding 1/2 to 1/2. So if we added the top numbers, we'd get 2, and if we added the bottom numbers, we'd get 4. But, well, that can't be right, because 2 over 4 simplifies to 1/2. And if you add 1/2 and 1/2, you should get a whole, not a half. Uh-oh, we must have broke some sort of math rule. I'm out of here. Okay, here's what we did wrong. It turns out that there's some important math rules called order of operations that say you have to do multiplication and division before you do addition and subtraction. Now, because fractions are just division problems, if you just added the top numbers and added the bottom numbers, you'd be breaking those rules because you would be doing the addition before the division. So, what are we going to do instead? Well, fortunately, there's a trick that lets us work around the order of operation rules and add fractions without dividing. But there's a catch. It only works for fractions that have the same bottom numbers. The trick is, if fractions have the same bottom numbers, we can add them by just adding the top numbers together and keeping the same bottom number in our answer. For example, to add 1/2 and 1/2, we just add the top numbers and 1 plus 1 gives us 2. But we don't add the bottom numbers. We just use the same bottom number in the answer, which is 2. So 2 over 2 is a whole fraction. And that makes sense, because if you add 1/2 and 1/2, you get a whole. Let's see a few more examples. Like this one. 5 over 16 plus 2 over 16. Again, since the bottom numbers are the same, it's easy to add these fractions. All we do is add the top numbers together. 5 plus 2 equals 7, and that's the top number of our answer. Then we just keep 16 as the bottom number of our answer. So, 5 over 16 plus 2 over 16 equals 7 over 16. Pretty easy, huh? But what about subtracting fractions? Does that work the same way? Yep, if the bottom numbers are the same, all you have to do is subtract the top numbers and keep the same bottom number in your answer. Here's an example of subtracting fractions with the same bottom numbers. 5 over 9 minus 2 over 9. First, we subtract the top numbers. 5 minus 2 equals 3. Then we just write the same bottom number in our answer, 9. So 5 over 9 minus 2 over 9 is 3 over 9. Yep, adding and subtracting fractions with the same bottom numbers is easy. And there's a special name for problems like this. It's called adding or subtracting like fractions. A teacher once told me that they're called like fractions because the bottom numbers are the same, or alike. But I think it's because they secretly like each other. Just kidding. But seriously, like fractions are easy to add with the trick we just learned. But what happens if you want to add two unlike fractions? What do you do if you have fractions with different bottom numbers? Unfortunately, the only way we can add unlike fractions without doing the division first is to change them so that they do have the same bottom numbers. In other words, we need to change our unlike fractions into like fractions so we can just use our trick. In math language, that's called finding a common denominator. Now remember that a denominator is just a fancy math word for the bottom number of a fraction. And common just means that they're the same. So, how do we find a common denominator so that we can add or subtract unlike fractions? That's what we're going to learn in the next video. But before you move on, be sure to do the exercises for this section. Learn more at mathantics.com.